Bandits have killed a soldier, Major MS Samalia, who was traveling to the Kano-Maiduguri road on Saturday. Samalia, before his death, was the AG commanding officer of the 196 Afumbios Battalion in the Isiala Ungwa area of Abia State. A military source told Sahara reporters that the deceased was returning from a station in Abia State to his family when the unfortunate incident occurred. He said, "This is Major Samalia of 145 BNOC in Isiala Gwa, Abia State. He was attacked by armed bandits on the Kano Maiduguri road while going home to see his family." Abia State was his unit before he died. "This is saddening, and the country is annoying. Both his wife and children now are on their own." The development comes amid rising insecurity in the country, with soldiers becoming one of those worst hit in the fight against the situation. Sahara reporters had chronicled the plight in different soldiers pleading the war against Boko Haram in the northeast region of the country. A soldier told Sahara reporters that many of his Sikh colleagues were still in the bush fighting Boko Harams to the detriment of their health following the death of one of them. "He was sick here in the bush, but he went home and died." "The man had been dying slowly. I'm tired of the country. I don't feel happy when wrong things are happening. I will soon quit the army to work in a place where I have freedom of speech," he had said. "We still have some people that are medically unfit but are still here, which isn't supposed to be so. It's sad because if this were to be United Nations operations or that of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, they will drop you even if it's only high blood pressure that you have. But now, those that have health issues are here in the bush fighting. Were it to be an operation that they feel they will make more and get other benefits, they will deny them. This should not be a case, but what are we going to do? That is the situation we find ourselves in at the moment." What is your thought about this that has been said? What is your reaction to this? Insecurity is, you know, has been the order of the day in Nigeria for a very long time, and probably the leaders of Nigeria are not doing anything concerning it. We have heard about the soldier that was killed. Ismailia, before his death, was the AG commanding officer of the 196 Afimbios Battalion in the Isiala Ungwa area of Abia State. He was the commanding officer, but now he is dead. He was killed by bandits. This is as a result of the level of insecurity that we have in Nigeria. People are losing their loved ones due to the level of insecurity in Nigeria. What is your thought about this? Someone who has been in service for a very long time just lose his life, and according to the news, his families, his wife and children are now on their own. This is so sad, and the country is annoying. Nigeria is so annoying because series of things are happening. Bad things are happening in Nigeria, according to a soldier that had told some reporters that many of his colleagues are so sick, and yet they are still in the bush fighting Boko Harams to the detriment of their health following the death of one of them. People are not medically, they are not medically sound. you are taking them to the war front. What do you expect of them? Are you trying to kill them, or you are trying, you know, to secure the lives of the rest citizens? People who should face war should be people who are healed and hearty, people who are complete, people who have nothing, you know, like sickness within them. But whereas you have people who are sick, colleagues who are sick and yet are still fighting in the bush, they are fighting against people who are 100% okay. What do you expect from them? What is your thought about this? According to the soldier who spoke to Sahara Reporters, said, "We still have some people that are medically unfit but are still here, which isn't supposed to be so. It is sad because if, you know, there were to be a United Nations operation or that of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, they will have dropped even if it is only high blood pressure that you have." What is your thought about this? To become the soldier, a military man in Nigeria, is not, you know, a easy stuff. To become a military man in Nigeria, you need to be strong, because look at what these people are facing. Even when you have sickness in your body, you are still chosen to go and face war. What is your thought about this? I would like you to share your own point of view with us on this that has been said. I'd like you to share your own reaction with us on this. But before we go, let's see people's reactions and know their thoughts about this. Let's see what people have felt concerning the present situation of things in Nigeria. Iwolode Aziz Adelani reacted to this and said, "It is sad to lose this gallant soldier. This is why we are calling on Nigeria government to adopt holistic approach in tackling insecurity everywhere in Nigeria." What is your thought about this? Unknown gunmen have attacked a soldier in Nigeria, a gallant soldier at that. It is so sad that we lose this gallant soldier. Now, these people attacked bandits, they attacked unknown gunmen. Initially, IPOB used to be tagged unknown gunmen if anything should happen. But now that the leader has been, you know, detained, who do you want to say is behind all this? Will you say it is the detained IPOB leader that is behind this? Things are really happening in this country. This is why we have been calling on Nigerian government to adopt holistic approach in tackling insecurity everywhere in Nigeria. What is your thought about this? We would like you to drop your reaction to this. Well, let's move further and see what other people's reactions is on this. Danito Kuta also reacted to this and said, "The last time I checked, this officer is from the north, and Helrify and Gumi believe that bandits only kidnapped to collect ransom. Until we rise to stand for the truth, we will continue to be the casualty of our own deception. May the gentle soul of Somalia rest in perfect peace." That is what Danito have said. What is your own reaction to this? Don't you think Danito has just spoken the truth? Because if you could remember vividly that this man was killed in the north, and it is obvious, and now, you know, Helrify and Gumi believe that bandits only kidnapped to collect ransom. They don't kill their victim, they only collect ransom from them and free them. That is what Gumi and Helrify have said, and that is what they believe in. Until we stand for the truth, according to what Danito has said, until we stand for the truth, all these things will continue, because it is due to our own deception. We will continue to be the casualty of our own deception if we continue like this. What is your thought about this? I'd like you to share your own point of view with us on what has been said. We have heard about the bandit who have killed a Nigerian military commanding officer on the highway when he was returning home to his family. I'd like you to drop your reaction to this.